Samuel Amadu, and the games are still on, and we now almost getting another encounter started. This at Queens Seasiders, and let's up in action, and a second women's fixtures today, women's game today in this in the ongoing Prudent Energy Handball Premier League campaign. It's a great one we are seeing, and as Ijeoma did said earlier, this is the first sports, the first contact sports competition that will be holding since the PTF Presidential Task Force, since the Presidential Task Force did unbanned all contact sports and ensure that yes, they restart sports after. It's great, the game is already started, and we can see Seasiders Babes from Lagos now with the early attack against their opponents. It's been a great games we've watched so far. Exciting to see how well these teams have really been able to express themselves in various games they've had in since the opening of this competition on Saturday. And it's quite exciting to see handball being a shiny light for other sports, becoming the first competitive contact sports to have a league campaign or a league competition of any form up and running since the lockdown. And they are obeying the globally respected and PTF set COVID-19 protocols as the event progresses. It is without fans, and everyone involved is respectfully taking to heads authorities instructions. Now there's a Queens on the attack. They are in search for the first goal, still goalless in this game. Unfortunately, they couldn't really do much from there. Desert Queens has lost two games back to back and now need to do better to avoid a slip against Seasider Babes, who are also another high-flying side in this competition with impressive stats. I understand they have two wins already. Be careful. The cables are Seasider Babes are in front, the Lagos side. What a throw. She almost got that in. And that is a brilliant effort of Johnson Sharifat. She almost got from there. Her side definitely has been a huge advantage for her side. And she's looking set to make her side double their lead. A missed opportunity there for Seasiders. Sorry for Desert Queens, but now wasted. Seasiders now on the run. They are hoping to add another. Unfortunately, she was blocked. Couldn't make anything out of that. Well, IJ, you see, women's play handball, and I don't know what you make of this. It's really interesting.
Wow, it's an exciting one. It's great to see ladies, you know, matured women here in the game of handball. That's great. You know, this the things we're expecting to see in other sports. And it's great to see that the league is not just for the men only. However, that's what I thought earlier until I'm here. So it's great to see ladies doing well. And wow, it's a huge one. I don't know what we're expecting to, how the match is going to end. Sam, what do you think?
Yeah, we just saw the Babatunde Taiwo coming close to possibly doubling the advantage of Seasiders, but again, her efforts really didn't go as anticipated as it went wide. Still a one goal lead for Seasiders in this game. They have just a very slim advantage. Desert Queens are fighting hard to crawl back. Desert Queen from Cassina in playing from right to left. Desert Queens plays from right to left. Seasiders playing from left to right. Now the game is level. Desert Queens finally got one back. Same way they did started in their last games. What a throw. Unfortunately, her effort was redirected and she has been booked for that. Shekina Sarifat. Shekoni Sarifat, rather, with that block there, and she goes into the book. A chance for Seasiders, but again, great defending. Being masterminded by Sarifat yet again. They are now inching forward in search for the second goal of the game. Can they get in front against Seasiders? No, that chance wasn't really a possible one. It didn't go according to plan. Seasiders now having an opportunity. Seasiders looks a very young and athletic side. However, they haven't really done very much in attack, trying to read the defense very well. Such a very mature and hefty ladies in that defense line. Surely you must think twice and have your plans well cut out before you really could penetrate that defense. Solid one there. And surely Seasiders must go an extra mile to penetrate them. She's still trying to sneak in, but no way. She was blocked out. Sadia Aziz with the ball as she makes a long one. Great effort. Matthew Esther with that apron. And on the other end, the counter attack, she slips through. But again, the goalkeeper, but seemed like they have won a 7-meter throw. A great advantage for Desert Queens. Despite being denied from close range, but they finally won themselves an opportunity from the spot, and that it will be and she scores. Brilliant goal from Yakubu Halima. Halima did make that count. Great effort. A change in goal for Desert Queens, for Seasiders rather. the goalkeeper needed to catch some greats after failing to stop that effort from Halimat. It's 2-2 now between these two sides. We can't wait to see how well they could get to outwit each other. What definitely will be a great battle. Lagos side versus the Katsina ladies. Great, great effort. That may just not count yet, but they are still in advantage and possession of the ball. Desert Queens did score again, and who did that? You could have guessed wrong. It was Sharifat. She made that finish with some class. A great effort there. Now Desert Queens are in front. It's quite difficult to tell how Seasiders have struggled to impose themselves in this game against Desert Queens, who had lost their opening two games. And Seasiders came into this contest on the high with two wins on the bounce, but we haven't really seen much of them in this game. They meet in the very solid side, long throw there, she passed it through. Oh my goodness, she couldn't connect. Akwada Bami, she couldn't connect to that ball, and the ball slips back into the hands of Seasiders. They are on the attack now, inching into the 9-meter area. They see how the ball is down, but they are still in possession of the ball. Desert Queens in search of a fourth goal, but that won't come through. They are all still on the attack. Still a very slender lead for Desert Queens. However, Seasider Babes needs to do more. So find a breakthrough against Desert Queens. Great pass. And she shot from distance, still having the ball there. Seasiders still very much in possession. She almost got through there, but again, that was not to happen. Hey Jemma, you've seen the game so far. It seems a bit very tight.
Yes.
These two teams are really struggling to see the end of each other. Great defending, I must say, but I don't know, what do you make of their efforts so far? Especially seeing the side in front, Desert Queens from Katsina.
Yeah, absolutely true. You know, it's a very intense game. It's going to be a very tight one. We can even see from the score sheet, just 3-2, in up to about 15 minutes or more. Just as you said, it's going to be a very tight one. And I would say kudos to the Lagos side, you know, Seasiders Babe. It's not easy coming up with a team against a macho kind of, you know, you see the girls from the Katsina side, they are so heavy, you know, it's not easy. But let's see, anything is possible.
So you feel the physique for the Desert Queens would definitely be a huge worry for the Lagos ladies.
Yeah, of course.
Because it seems that is really counting against them.
Yes. And you could also count in the advantage of the Desert Queens, really. You could see some of the goals they've been trying to prevent, you know. The defenders really they are on top of their game, they know what they're doing, they're not here to play. So let's see, but the other girls from Lagos, they are good to an extent. Anything is possible. I have an eye for them, for the Lagos side, and hopefully anything is possible.
But looking at how these Desert Queens have also really set up themselves, we think they do have a chance despite losing a couple of games they've played so far in this competition. And now they're in search of their first win. Do you think that could possibly a huge point of inspiration to possibly getting something out of this game?
Yeah, true. Anyway, but we should also not forget that skills, hard work, and other things come to play. Apart from your physique, you know, they are good. But I see that the girls from the Lagos side, they are more athletic than they are, you know, and they also know what they are here to do. Let's see, what anything is possible. I just believe that the Lagos girls could get the win, maximum win out of this place.
All right, the game is back on again on the floor, and the Seasiders are in possession of the ball, and they are now inching close to the 9 meters area, trying to make those slick passes, see out each other, and possibly find a means past the defense of the beach, the Desert Queens. Ball was almost gonna go in, but the goalpost was again at the rescue of the goalkeeper. She almost could have considered the third goal of the game, but again, they are very much in it. Seasiders are yet to find a breakthrough. They are struggling to really find a way past the defense, but definitely they know they have a lot to do to gain an advantage. Down. 3-2 is the scoreline. Desert Queen still with a very narrow lead over Seasiders. I won't argue the fact that, well, the Desert Queen girls are quite solid. Interesting how they look structurally. I would have given Lagos side a chance on assessing this body build they do possess. I say, wow, they are on the attack yet again, but seem like Seasiders quite do well to defend that. They are really defending well, Seasiders now, but can they really make the better of what they've done so far in the final thoughts by scoring more goals? Yes, great one. Seasiders are back in it. They have defended well and now been able to get back on level terms. Crawling back from 2 goals down and now level. a yellow card to Desert Queens Sheriff Hart. An opportunity for Seaside to score, and she did. Scored from there, 7 meters. Ochonia Ata. Ochonia Ata provided that fourth goal for Seasiders. They are back in front. They are in front for the first time in the game, I must say. And it's really, really a hard-fought one. They've had put up a very solid defensive structure, which has managed to really keep Desert Queens at bay. But again, the Desert Queens are finally getting their mojo again. They've scored, and it's 4-4 yet again. Concentration is pretty very much important in a competition like this. Quite a huge luck there. And she scores. She did score and recover the lead for Seasiders. Yet again. She almost wanted to score that goal, but she was blocked. John Blessing there. A counter attack there. She's on the run. Can she make it a one? She still had the ball. Oh my goodness. She was almost going to do another rebound, but that definitely will not go through. As a quick response was made by Akpala Bamiche. Great effort there. She got into the end of that run and did finish brilliantly from the right wing. Great effort, great strike, and perfect finish. Seasiders also yet again on the attack. It is 5-5 so far. Both sides with an end-to-end. She slips in and she scores. Great effort. Fine finish. It's 6-6 again. Seasiders sinks very much in this as they have scored again. Ismail Habibat with that effort. Good goalkeeping there from Seasider goalkeeper. She scores. Seasiders now in front. Ata once again providing that seventh goal of the game for the Seasider babes. What a strike. And it did count. It did count. Yakubu Halimat was the provider of that goal. She was resolute despite going down, but still found her space to slot in the equalizer for Desert Queens. But well, as we draw close to the closing stages of the first period, yeah, five minutes left to play in this first period. I don't know, what do you see about how these two teams have really been at each other's neck? 7-7 the scoreline, especially judging by how well they've composed themselves defensively and possibly structured themselves in attack. Another goal there. Well, the lead seems back again in the hands of Seasiders. Courtesy of Musbau Khadija. Yeah, I'm up with it, IJ. What do you think? Counter attack there. She scored again. Now a two-goal cushion for Seasider Babes. Great effort from Adebisi Tomoloju, with that great effort. Yeah, you spoke very well about Seasiders earlier, and it seems they are gradually getting to really find their mojo, especially utilizing pretty well their athleticism and their youthfulness, especially going forward.
Yeah, true. I said that earlier, and we can see, you know, they're on the lead right now. So I would just say, basically, the game has been an exciting one, really, really. You think we have the guys, you know, on court, but it's the ladies, and you could see the kind of strength, the energy, you know, the run-up play and all of that. It's been an exciting one, really. It's been a great one. I didn't expect, you know, most times people might not expect to get this from ladies, but we can see so much what these women are doing. You can compare this game to any, you know, male game that is going to play today or maybe during throughout the league this period. So yeah, it's a great one.
Yeah, but if you look at how it's been before the short break, if you'll have been the coach of Delta Queens, what would you have told them? Well, two goes down, but well, they've also really been a very solid side too so far in this game.
Yeah, I'll tell them to come up, to still be strong. You know, their defense is quite tight. Their defense is really, really tight, and they know what they are doing when they are, you know, down there. So I'll just tell the girls to be strong, to keep on. You know, they can with their build, they can, you know, suppress the skills of the Lagos girls, of the girls of the Seasider Babes. So I just tell them to keep up what they're doing. The girls are not doing any bad, but I just see something great. I see something great with the girls from Lagos.
Yeah, well, exciting to see. Seasiders are really impressing. Another opportunity there. They have converted that. Great effort. 3-goal lead now opened by Seasiders. Well, it's interesting, and it seems not too much of an impact has the breakdown for the Babes or the Queens from Castina. They are now behind 3 goals. Still all the attack yet again is Seasider Babes itching for more. Again, they added another. Andrew Betty with that goal. Okay. to move up there. I'm going to move up. Four goal lead now opened by Seasiders. Opportunity for Desert Queens to score, and they did. Abdultalib Hazia did make that count. Great, great effort there.
Siders Babes of Lagos, Adorable Angels of Ilorin, Kada.
We're at half time already, as you could see from here.
What cannot express how I feel? I'm very elated, very happy.
It's half time already, as you can see from here, from the inside the Indo Sports Hall of MKO Abiola Stadium in Abuja. Between Desert Queens and Seasiders, the Lagos side leads with 11 goals to 9 to the Katsina Girls. And as much as we look forward to the second half, the second period of the game, we will be doing some post-match analysis right here. I, Cosmos, and Ijoma will be talking through to you from here, and again to your. Everyone around the world can keep an eye on this. Stay glued to your screens from everywhere you are.
Prudent Energy Premier League Season 3, proudly sponsored by Prudent Energy and Service Limited.
We have 22 participating teams, 12 male teams and 10 female teams. The teams are Kano Pillars of Kano, Safety Shooters of FRSC, the Defenders of Civil Defense, Seasiders of Lagos, Niger United of MENA, Kada Stars of Kaduna, COAS Shooters of Nigeria Army, Plateau Vipers of Jos, Rima Strikers of Sokoto, Delta Force of Asaba, Offline Stars of Lokoja, Borno Spiders of Maiduguri. In female categories, we have Safety Babes of FRSC, Plateau Peacock of Jos, Edo Dynamos of Benin City, Imo Grasshoppers of Owerri, Seasiders Babes of Lagos, Adorable Angels of Ilorin, Kada Queen of Kaduna, Benue Queens of Makurdi, Defenders Babes of Civil Defense, Desert Queens of Katsina,
The event is proudly sponsored by Prudent Energy and Service Limited.
Prudent Energy Premier League Season 3, proudly sponsored by Prudent Energy and Service Limited.
We have 22 participating teams, 12 male teams and 10 female teams. The teams are Kano Pillars of Kano, Safety Shooters of FRSC, the Defenders of Civil Defense, Seasiders of Lagos, Niger United of Mena, Kada Stars of Kaduna, COAS Shooters of Nigeria Army, Plateau Vipers of Jos, Rima Strikers of Sokoto, Delta Force of Asaba, Offline Stars of Lokoja, Borno Spiders of Maiduguri. In female categories, we have Safety Babes of FRSC, Plateau Peacock of Jos, Edo Dynamos of Benin City, Imo Grasshoppers of Owerri, Seasiders Babes of Lagos, Adorable Angels of Ilorin, Kada Queen of Kaduna, Benue Queens of Makurdi, Defenders Babes of Civil Defense, Desert Queens of Katsina. The event is proudly sponsored by Prudent Energy and Service Limited.
Prudent Energy Premier League Season 3, proudly sponsored by Prudent Energy and Service Limited.
We have 22 participating teams, 12 male teams and 10 female teams. The teams are Kano Pillars of Kano, Safety Shooters of FRSC, the Defenders of Civil Defense, Seasiders of Lagos, Niger United of Mena, Kada Stars of Kaduna, COAS Shooters of Nigeria Army, Plateau Vipers of Jos, Rima Strikers of Sokoto, Delta Force of Asaba, Offline Stars of Lokoja, Borno Spiders of Maiduguri. In female categories, we have Safety Babes of FRSC, Plateau Peacock of Jos, Edo Dynamos of Benin City, Imo Grasshoppers of Owerri, Seasiders Babes of Lagos, Adorable Angels of Ilorin, Kada Queen of Kaduna, Benue Queens of Makurdi, Defenders Babes of Civil Defense, Desert Queens of Katsina. The event is proudly sponsored by Prudent Energy and Service Limited.
Prudent Energy Premier League Season 3, proudly sponsored by Prudent Energy and Service Limited.
What cannot express how I feel? I'm very elated, very happy, very satisfied with the turnout. And I mean, what else can we say? Showing appreciation for the patronage and the custom that we've got from our customers. I mean, we're really very happy hosting our customers.
Yeah. Okay, so we just finished the first period. Of course, the second period will be starting pretty soon. Yes, of course, the lady's voice who we're hearing is actually Ijeoma Okibu of the News Agency of Nigeria. IJ, how are you?
Fine, I'm good, thank you.
And of course, Samuel Amadu, I and him has been going through this for the past 2 days now. And then let's talk about this here. Let me start with you, Samuel. Both of you have been running the commentary, and it looks as if is Lagos struggling. Lagos are on top of the log anyway with 6 points. The win this, they will go to 9 maximum points. Are they struggling?
Yeah, for me, I think so far in this game, definitely they had a very sluggish start, but again, they seem to have really recovered their mojo and doing everything possible to really recover and come back into the game. Initially, they seem to have come up against a very solid and also tough defensive side like Desert Queens, but now it's great they are back in front, though enjoying a very steam lead. But again, it speaks volume about how enduring they could be, and you know how hard fighting they also could have set themselves off, especially ending the first period. But Desert Queens, no doubt, have also held their own for that first period. Unfortunately, they couldn't really maintain that form in which they started the game with.
All right, IJ, which of these two teams so far has impressed you and why?
Well, so much is the girls from Lagos, the Seasiders. When the game started, you know, it was looking like it was going to be one-sided because you see the desert babes, you know, I would say their physique, you know, and then their defense is very, very solid. So you could see that it was to an extent more like intimidating the Lagos girls. But I've always known that there's something about the girls, their youthfulness, talking about the girls from the Seasiders, their youthfulness, their athleticism, or how do I put it, you know, it showed so much on the court here. And of course, same, it's so visible and obvious on the score sheet. So, okay, going forward, of course, we expect something better, much more better from the girls from Lagos.
Of course, we expect so much more better. And of course, they are coming to the pitch. Yes, the Lagos Seasider babes are coming to the pitch. And yes, the Desert Queens are also there as well. And that is what we're going to be seeing in the second period. Will Lagos Seasider babes increase the lead on the table of the Nigeria Prudent Energy Handball League, or Desert Queens get their first win? Time will tell.
No, let me test. Maybe this okay. Let me test. So that's the auto.
As you can see, the game is back up and running, and the teams are now fighting to approve their class in the second period of the game. Seasider babes still holding a slender 2-goal lead here against Desert Queens. Desert Queens on the attack. They have a chance to possibly do threaten the Seasiders, but they really couldn't make anything out of it. They still have an advantage. She's shot. Great, great attempt there from the Desert Queens. But on the other hand, they have conceded their 12th goal of the game. It's now a 3-goal advantage for Seasiders. They've clearly now resumed Seasiders have restarted the half as high as they ended it. What an effort. She's was aiming to send it far corner, but the ball was denied by the Woodwork. Great chance for Desert Queens. John Blessing leading the attack, but again, nothing really hard come out of that. Seasiders defending with all their energy and hoping to retain their 3-goal lead against Desert Queens. They're on their own attack again, trying to penetrate there. Can they get something in? Still hovering around the defense of Desert Queens. A great chance there, but great defending same time, and save rather from the goalkeeper of Desert Queens. Sisa that's in position of the ball, running in from the edge, but she did struck from that great run, great finish. Seasiders still much in the mix. They are yet to concede in this second half, but still angling for more. Great effort there. Yakubu Halimat almost scored from that opportunity, but yet again the goalkeeper came to Seasiders' rescue. A great effort there, great goalkeeping there from Babatunde Kehinde. We have the Babatunde is very much involved for Seasiders. The Taiwo and Kehinde is the twin sisters. Both currently on the floor. Great one, she almost did score, but was denied. The goalkeeper threw her body in the way to stop the ball. What a block, and possibly a 7 meters may be awarded here. It's impressive to see how Seasiders have really, really reorganized themselves at the back line. They have avoided conceding any goal in this second half. And good effort too from Seasiders, from Desert Queens goalkeeper Ahmed Naimat. Ahmed Naimat did very well in goal to save that one from a 7 meter throw. They yet again threw away another opportunity. A long one there, she sneaks in, she's through, and that is Babatunde. Kende, Babatunde Taiwo rather, scoring this one. Great, great strike from Taiwo. Now, the lead has now begin to rise. Babatunde's strike becomes the 13th goal of the game for Seasiders. Yet another save. A long throw there, but was kept out. By Desert Queens defender. Seasiders still moving on in search of their 14th goal of the game and being keen to open up a gap. She sneaks through and slips it underneath the goalkeeper to secure the 14th goal of the game. Ismail Habibat. Scored that 14th goal of the game for Seasider Babes. Yet again. Long ball, she's free yet again. She sneaks it through, straight into the top right corner. The goalkeeper could not do much to deny her. Fantastic finish for Gbamire Grace. Now a 6-goal lead open now for Seasiders. They are pulling away. Ijeoma, I don't know what you see now. Just like we had predicted, Seasiders are now very much in the lead and looking set to pull away so easily. They have opened up the defense and yet again with another goal. Great finish. What a classic effort. Why do you think Desert Queen's defense looks to be collapsing right about now?
Well, I really wouldn't know exactly what the problem is. I don't know but it looks in a way as if they have, the spirit is no more there, as if they are low in spirit, you know. And it's so evident. You can imagine 16-9. And you can't even compare them. If you look at the first half, you can see how defensively strong, you know, the other girls are, the Desert Queens girls are. Now you can see what's going on in the second half. They've just relaxed so much. I don't know if they're just being a bit too complacent or something, but hopefully let's see what will happen before the end of the game.
Yeah, well, but won't one say this probably could be accountable? The tiredness might be a reason why they're really struggling to hold on to such a youthful side like Seasiders. They've really shipped in a lot of goals now in the second period and yet to even find a means through. But not being able to score against a team like Seasiders in the second period, what would you say that could portend for Seasiders? Possibly being betterly, probably an improved defensive work, one must say, in the second period for Seasiders.
Yeah, I agree with you, Sam.
What's your thoughts?
Yes, I agree with you, Sam. A very improved improved work, a very improved and more organized defense right now. Really, you can see the way they are all moving back to defend, unlike before, unlike what was expected in the first half. And I think their organization is in a way affecting that of the Desert Queens.
now the 17th goal of the game, and also a 9-8 goal lead. It is now clearly a massive lead for Seaside Habibs. Nice efforts yet again, but seems like there was no power in that throw to have been able to slip past Babatunde Taiwo. Babatunde Kehinde, rather. Yet again, Taiwo is now involved on the other end, but she has been brought down inside the 7 meters area. And she could have been gifted a 7 meter throw, another advantage for Seasiders to raise their tally and also open the lead a bit wider. Can she make that count? Such a brilliant finish. Superb one. Matty Esther did that magic. Great efforts indeed, Matty Esther. She saw the dummy, the goalkeeper bought it, and helplessly fell for it. Brilliant efforts. 19-18-9, 8 goal lead, and still pulling clear. Babatunde Taiwo again confirms a wide margin of 10 goals for Seasiders. Crazy from ruthless finishing and superb build-up so far for Seasiders. Fine pass. She could have almost gotten there, but seems they do have an advantage. But definitely not a 7 meter throw. Still in search of their first goal in the second period speaks volume about how Desert Queens seem to have lost their mojo in this second period. She sticks through and still yet again. How did Babatunde Taiwo, Babatunde Kehinde, read that? She has been the major reason why Seasiders hasn't conceded in the second period. Incredible save she made there. Definitely, Desert Queens will be disappointed. They couldn't have yet find a means to see through, but they finally found the back of the net. Surprisingly, it took that long, but yet they've reduced Seasiders' lead to 9. First goal in the second period. How better they could become after that opportunity surely won't be respected. But against a very youthful and an enterprising Seasider Babes, it's really would be tough, seeing how well they've held out for so long before conceding their first goal in the second period. Yeah, they've made a waste of this chance, hoping around the defense of Desert Queens, but couldn't really get their 28th goal of the game and restore their 10 goal margin. Seems Desert Queens are tired of conceding more, and now key to reduce the deficit. That's really didn't fall through. A long one there, intercepted yet again, but still in advantage of Seasiders. great commendation must go to Babatunde Kehinde for really how strong, how efficacious she has been in goal. She has used all her energy and physique to really help keep Seasiders lead quite intact. Lots of concentration there, but still they have the chance. Long balls, and it goes in. She was never necessarily need to send that ball back again to her. Unfortunately, it was intercepted, and an opportunity yet again missed by Desert Queens to reduce their deficit. Still behind by 9 goals, and must do well to crawl back into this game. Seasiders in search of their 20th goal of the game, but seem that could still be a mirage at this point. No doubt, it looks like Desert Queens are clearly tired of shipping in more goals, but looking how to formidably get to increase their attacking tempo. And they did yet again delivered. Eleventh goal of the game coming through for Desert Queens. The tally being reduced to 8 goal. Finally, the clock go 20. What a finish. Akpala Bamise yet at it again. She yet again reduced the scoreline for Desert Queens. And the infringement there. Desert Queen survived that attack from Seasiders. And as you could hear, only 10 minutes left to play in this second half between Desert Queens and Sea Babes. An opportunity for Desert Queens to add another, but you could see a very good goalkeeping there. Double save. Great effort. She continues to impress. But Babatunde Kehinde, quite composed, calm and collected inside the area. Great opportunity. She still had a grab of the ball, but slips off her and possibly winning for herself a 7 meters throw. Great chance for Seasiders, for Desert Queens to pull one back. Yakubu Halima with the task to reduce the deficit here. Save. Yakubu, finally! She did her skillfully. She understood very well that beating Kehinde would be an uphill task. But again, she managed to send her through, hitting the ball with a grand and ensuring it did slip past Babatunde Kehinde for their 13th goal of the game. Now, reducing their disadvantage to 7. Long one, but she will have anticipated the goalpost being higher than that for it to have gone in. Such a miss and a great, great escape for this queen. They are on the attack now, sneaking through, and she did score. Well taken effort. Fantastic finish from Falibu Nasara. Gradually, they are waking up from their slumber and getting back into contention. A timeout being called here. We have only a few minutes left, final 5 minutes possibly, to play in this encounter, and clearly very, very important that such calls come through. Seasiders with a 6-goal lead, and their coach needed these moments to speak to the players. They seem to have lost concentration, and now the referee is calling for the return of the game as actions resume on the floor. A 6-goal lead with 5 minutes left to play here. Seasiders must stay on top to avoid a slip up. She makes that effort, read out briefly, but went inches wide. Quite a marginal miss, I must say. Great effort from Matty Wester for Seasiders. On the other end, we do have Desert Queens on the attack. They seem to be well aware of why they needed to be back in this contest, and did fire from long range inside the 9 meters, but that effort couldn't really trouble the goalkeeper as she calmly parry the ball out of play. See that Siders now in the attack. They are on the run in such goal. She slips through and she scores. What a run. What a finish. But seems a foul was recorded there. And the goal will not count. And a 2-minute suspension to one of Desert Queen's star player, John Blessing. That won't again count. Some sort of infringement also recorded there again. However, Seaside are still in advantage. They will have to keep enduring to keep up. She sneaks through yet again, replicating the same brilliance. Finally, her goal stands. Andrew Betty. Sorry, Musbel Khadijat with that effort. She has now made it seven. Yeah, made it seven. Seven goal difference now between these two teams. A miscommunication there. Player dreading into the pitch, and that has received the attention of the umpires. They are addressing the matter, and she has suffered a 2 minutes suspension and won't have a chance of returning to the pitch. The player involved is Andrew Betty, actually. An opposite number of Musbel Khadijat, who did scored much earlier for Seasider Babes. An attacking opportunity for Seasiders yet again to do pull away and add more to their tally. Yet again, they had made that happen. Courtesy of Babatunde Taiwo. She has been a terrific form in this game. And now, with 22 goals against for Seasiders and 14 yet. She slips through, she's in, and she managed to seek that in. Great finish there from Desert Queens talisman Yakubu Halimat. She has been accountable for most goals in this encounter for Desert Queens, and yet again still proving her red hot form in front of goal. Boy, Jim, I don't know, it seems now becoming a huge challenge for Desert Queens to really crawl back into this game. I don't know, much like they are almost out and done already.
Yeah, obviously that's what it looks like, you know. I foresaw that from the beginning. You know, earlier they started in the first half, they started with huge pace, you know, from the back. You could see their defensive prowess was so great at that time. But then sadly, while that was going on, you could still also see what the Seasider Queens had in mind. You could see, you'll be able to read that, you know, through their play in the court. So obviously, it's just going the way I thought it would. You know, just so sadly that the goal margin is so long. It's about over 6-7 points or so. But then let's see. I just know that we are just sure that the Lagos Seasiders will be able to take home the maximum points here. Yes, sir.
Yet again. Babatunde Taiwo, yet involved in this. She knows best how to sneak past that defense. Definitely, it's something she had learned over time and knows the weakest link in this side. Fantastic effort there. Desert Queens pull one back yet again by Agu Chika. Fantastic efforts from her. 16th goal for Desert Queens. Yeah, a minute left to play. Great opportunity intercepted, but now falls back in the hands of Seasiders. They almost scored. But imagine the kind of cover that Babatunde Kehinde has provided in the defense. Seasiders surely has put on display their energy and pace, and they have managed to pull through. Final seconds, 30 seconds of the game, and that might just be that for Seasiders, claiming their third win of this competition, a massive one at that, condemning their opponents, Desert Queens, to their third defeat to in this league competition. It's over. It is over. It is over. No doubt, Desert Queens will be disappointed. They surely won't have hope to crawl back into this contest and what somehow fight back to make something out of this contest, especially recalling suffering two opening defeats in this league season against a very high flying side like Seasiders. But unfortunately, it didn't go according to plans for Desert Queens, and they will definitely play Delhi for how poorly they have organized themselves in the second period. They started very well, but again, it seems their strength did fail them at the latter stages, and no doubt they will have to really look forward to the next game, the fourth game of the league campaign, to possibly hope to celebrate their first win of the league. Fantastic show from our Seasiders youth athletic side. They pulled through, celebrating their third win in a row and retain their third spot on the log. Great performance, great game. Ijama, well, it seems clearly we've seen how it turned out, and no doubt the youthfulness of Seasiders did help them through, and it seems they saved their strength for the tail end of the game and did make a huge difference in how well they were able to grind out the results.
True. It always appears like Lagos is a hub for sports. Anytime you see a Lagos team playing, you know, you have your eyes open and be expecting something great from them. So we look forward to looking at Seasiders on, you know, from now on, expecting that they should always be top of their top already. So we expect something better always from them, and hopefully let's see how they cope before the end of the league.
All right, great question. Cosmos too is very much here with us, and he won't want to let in his thoughts about what he saw so far. Disappointing results for Desert Queens, three on the roll, and an exciting victory definitely for Seasiders. Lagos must be happy, even after their men did disappointed them losing not quite long in their third game of the competition.
Well, of course, it's a very simple thing, really, really simple thing, and the simple thing is that Lagos Seasider Babes are now on the log. They are leading the log of the Prudent Energy Handball League, and that is exactly what is happening right here at the Indosport Hall of the MKO Abiola Stadium. Yes, and that is exactly it.
Appreciation for the patronage and the custom that we've got from our customers. I mean, we're really very happy hosting our customers.